Recently, Relume released a new set of components, and I wanted to make a little design with one of them.
Just a little.
So I picked Header Hero 108. It has this really cool effect where you scroll and the center image grows until it fills up the screen, and then you scroll down to the next section. It's surprisingly easier than you think to modify this, so I'm gonna make a little something something. This isn't a comprehensive video like my last one, but I'm probably gonna teach you something you might not know. So stick around. Let's go to Figma.
So I've gone ahead and imported a hero header 108 into my file. And you can see that I've also got a bunch of images up here. These are all inspiration images from one of the previous Relume Rumbles. You can actually see that here. This is Alex versus Benton Woodring. It's a really fun match, by the way. If you've never seen it, go catch it. It's worth your time. So it comes with a bunch of inspiration like imagery and text and other inspo. So I put that in here, and then I also created this gradient, and we'll get to that later. So the first thing I want to do is actually import these images into the file. And this is just going to take a second. I'm basically just doing Command Option C and then Command Option V. And what that's doing is basically just copying the image style and then pasting it into another area. So it's just copying the fill and putting it onto another image. Now I'm looking for the right hero image for this particular section because I want it to look good when it's actually zoomed in. Now I'm gonna take the hero and I'm gonna change this to a font called Fountain. I'm gonna break that as well. This is just a really small section and we're not working in a giant system. So I'm just breaking it, changing it to Fountain. And then I'm gonna change that to extra light. Actually, we're gonna go to light. And then I'm gonna set this to 240 characters. And now it looks really big here. Oops, I accidentally added a crop there. I'm gonna change the type here to Greta, which is based on the original Relume League. And I'm gonna lower the line height. And that's actually because the line height, or rather the box height of the entire typeface is huge, even at 100%. So I'm just reducing that down to 80, so it's a little tighter. And then I'm gonna tighten up the letter spacing, but first throw it in uppercase. This is a kind of like the final form that I wanted in. I'll tighten this up, maybe -4% looks really good, which is the equivalent to -0.04 em. And I'm gonna do like a little eyebrow that goes over it. And we want this to be way smaller. So going with 40 here, regular weight, and I want this to be lowercase, not all caps. Whenever it comes to styling your text, I actually recommend if you're gonna do uppercase or lowercase, that you write it out as you intend and then style it with the uppercase instead. I'm increasing the line height and the letter spacing here because it's a lot smaller and we can get away with that. We don't want it to be too tight. Just gonna decrease the room between the two as well. Then decrease the max width on this actual paragraph unit. We'll probably put like a max width medium there. Let me change that to Suisse International. Big fan of this font. Changing that on the paragraph. Maybe tightening up that a little bit. I'm a big fan of tighter text. And then I'm gonna copy in some text from another file to this one. And I think it accidentally changed it to white, so just flipping it back to black. Gotta select it all before you change it. And for the buttons, I think that what we're gonna do for the buttons is actually increase the padding on these, make them a little bigger, and increase their presence on the page. So I'm gonna change the padding to maybe 32. It's currently 24. And maybe change the vertical padding to 16. That looks really nice. Go back to Swiss International. We have our serif for our big stuff and our sans serif for other stuff. I'm giving it semi-bold so that the buttons are a little bit more pronounced than the rest of the site is. I think that looks pretty good. Just checking the spacing here. Now, one idea I had with this particular image here is maybe this is like a doorway, right? Like if we're selling homes, maybe this could be like a doorway shape. So I'm just gonna bump this up to 300 on each side. I'm not measuring here, but if we do the same on each side and they're large numbers, it's gonna round it to a circle. And I think it looks like a little doorway so that when we're zooming in, it's gonna almost look like we're stepping through the door in a way. I'm also adding a tiny bit of border radius to the actual images. I wanna soften them up rather than all being hard edges all the way through, because our serif is really sharp, so I wanna add a little bit of variation there. Now, as our page scrolls and the image zooms in, you can look and see in these images there's a lot of play into sunlight and almost like a sunrise here. So what I wanna do is change the background color to be a sunset, and that is the gradient that we're gonna be working with. I also just realized that this particular image was the exact same, so it just needs a quick swap. But back to the sunrise, we're gonna end up using variables to make that happen. And I actually watched a sunrise time lapse and took screenshots from that in order to get the colors that we would use for this particular gradient happening. Okay, now that we're in Webflow, I've gone ahead and I've already moved the fonts over from Figma to Webflow. And I've also moved the imagery over. But I want to explain how this works. So there's an IX trigger on this page. And when you scroll to it on the desktop, we're basically changing the size and moving the actual image containers as you scroll. So this doesn't happen immediately. It only happens when you hit that IX trigger on the page. So basically the image is gaining 100 viewport width and 100 viewport height. So it takes up the entire screen no matter what. And the containers on the left and the right, they move individually on the left and the right as VW based on the grid that they are held in. So the first thing I'm gonna do is actually add a heading style hero here. And I'm gonna apply our size here. This is 240 divided by 16. That's how you get rems. You just take your number, you divide by 16. Gonna change this to our fountive. Accidentally open that panel there. Select our weight that we want, because this is our heading style hero. We don't really have to worry about sizing stuff, and this is a small example. Gonna reduce the line height to what we have in Figma. It was 80%, which in Webflow is just 0.8 or 0.8. Gonna add capitalization, set of the text. And then I'm actually going to remove our max width large on here, because I want the max width to be on the paragraph, not on the actual Greta font. Gonna change up our paragraph styling, starting with all paragraphs, and then gonna style the body because we want Suisse International to be the body all font. That way we can just style the buttons easier and style the paragraphs easier. And I'm gonna add a max width medium on here, which is what I actually said in Figma. And then I'm gonna start to center this on the actual page. So it currently is center aligned text, but I'm gonna add it anyways, just in case. You never know, fallback stuff. And I'm gonna actually take this hero, this heading style hero, and I'm gonna duplicate this so we can get our tiny little eyebrow. And I forgot this is an H1, so adding a text block instead. Gonna add text style sub hero, which is ironic because it's actually above the original hero. That's totally fine. Start to set the size on this thing. I'm gonna do 40, which is our pixel version from Figma, divided by 16 to get our rems, 2.5 rem, and at a height of 1, because this is 100% in Figma. 1 is 100%. And then do our letter spacing minus 0.03 em, which is a really easy way to convert from Figma to Webflow. Is basically just saying, like, you know, if in Figma your letter spacing is minus 3%, that means it's minus 0.03. So it's essentially a percentage in decimal form. Then I'm going to style our buttons here, selecting the pair button and adding 2 rem on both sides. Notice how I clicked that and it happened on the top and the bottom, the left and the right. If you click on a measurement and you change that measurement by holding Alt and then hitting Enter, it will change it on the opposite end as well. And Shift if you want to do all sides at the same time. So I'm just changing the font here to match our Figma file. Make sure all our settings are correct, setting our letter spacing as well. Like I said, I love typography to be a little tighter than normal, and we're going with it. Okay, so now that we've got all of our typography, buttons, heading in place, let's set a border radius on this image because we want it to be a lot like the Figma file where it's sort of that door shape, and then as you scroll, it becomes unlike a door. So it fills up the screen again. So I'm gonna add a variable and I'm gonna call this border radius. Actually, I'm gonna call it radius slash small, and that'll put it in a folder called radius size small. I wanna say that this is 300 rem. And I know I'm starting really big here, but that's actually because we're going to animate the global variable itself, not this particular radius to another radius. And I'm going to apply that to our parent container on the image. We can see that happening in real time. Our global variable hasn't changed, so naturally it's just going to be rounded the entire time. So I'm going to select our IX trigger, which is what changes the animation on the scroll. And I'm going to add a global variable for the parent of this image where our border radius is. And I'm going to add a variable value here. Our variable value that we're going to select is radius slash door. I put another one. Oops, accidentally got out of the interaction. It happens. And add a variable here. And I'm going to set this one to radius door as well. And I'm going to change that number. And normally you can't animate border radius in, you know, the IX panel, but because it's a global variable, boom, we go from a door to squaring off as soon as you get to full width, which is just a really cool feature for doing advanced animations without any extra work. All we did was add a variable and change the number. Super cool. So we're going to do the same thing actually with this section header 0108. We're going to change the background color here so we can have our little sunset effect. And I already have a background variable placed here. I did this earlier, just a little, you know, save some time. And this is like a dark blue color, and we're going to animate this sequentially, you know, brighter and brighter from, you know, dark blue to dark purple to an orange and then to like a white. So I'm going to add those variables in this IX panel. And let's just skip ahead. And now when we scroll, it's like a beautiful sunrise. Wow. Seriously, it's really cool effect with like no effort at all. Now, one of the problems is that our text is still black, but we're gonna play into variables one more time. I'm gonna add a new variable here under color. And I'm gonna call this color slash text color. And this is gonna be anything that is text in this particular hero. So I'm gonna start changing the color for our heading, the paragraphs, the button text, anything where the text needs to be white. I actually realized that the button text itself is black by default, but one really great thing is that we can actually change the color of the text itself to the color of the background. And because we're using a variable, it's going to change the background and the color of the text at the same time. So we're essentially going to have like a see-through button. And I'm going to add the variables for this particular text so that when we scroll, our text color changes from white to black. Now we're gonna do one more really cool thing here. So when I scroll, I want the text spacing of Greta to increase. So I'm gonna create a new size variable called letter spacing, or I'm gonna do letter spacing slash height. And we're gonna say that this is minus 0.04, which is what our current letter spacing is for the Greta text. We're gonna go back to our IX trigger, and we're gonna add a variable for Greta as well. So I'm gonna add the variable at the top, making sure to set our letter spacing variable to the variable that we set. That way we can actually animate it. That's probably a really important part. So got our variable, we got our variable set here. We can set our variable to spacing tight. Add one at the end, Actually, we're gonna move it up. We wanna actually be able to see it before we scroll all the way to the bottom. So, gonna move that to the top. Before we even, you know, start seeing the images move, we wanna see that text start to change a little bit. So once again, adding the correct variable in the correct spot and changing that letter spacing to 0.2. So now when we scroll, we get the door effect, we get the background color change, and we get this really amazing letter spacing change that normally you can't animate through the interaction panel. But now, using global variables, it's super easy. And this looks like something that, you know, could be done with like GSAP or something. This is amazing, and it took no effort. Isn't that amazing? I mean, seriously, this is no work.
See, that's a really cool component, and even with the smallest tweaks, you can make it look amazing. More importantly, clients will love how advanced and unusual it looks, despite being only a click or a copy paste away. I'd love to see what you come up with using this component. Send it to us, post it, like, subscribe. See you next time.